It's a very good afternoon, everyone, and welcome along to our coverage of the FIH Hockey Olympic Qualifiers. Still very much all to play for here in Taranaki, as New Zealand host Korea, a very tightly fought contest in the first game yesterday. The Black Sticks leading 3-2 coming into this one. Today, win or bust for both, with Tokyo 2020 the ultimate prize to be had. New Zealand yesterday in front of a really good crowd here at the Taranaki Hockey Club. They just could not shrug off the attention of Korea at times, who played with great confidence to try and upset the Black Sticks, and three times New Zealand led yesterday. But Korea are a team of fighters, twice equalizing. Could have been even better for Korea, but for important contributions from Leon Haywood in the New Zealand goal. In the end, it was a relatively straightforward day on Saturday, with victories for Great Britain, men's and women's teams against Malaysia and Chile respectively. Both Indian teams will be there in Tokyo too. German teams giving themselves a real chance coming into the action later. This is the best of the action from yesterday. Jeunesse getting the opening goal for New Zealand, only to be pegged back by Korea. And then Jeunesse was at it again. Just a tidy finish, having been fed by Childs. The leveller coming from the danger that is Jang Jong-hyun from a penalty stroke. And how about this for a cross from Jeunesse to feed Childs, returning the favour. And in the end, it turned out to be the match-winning moment. So the shadow of Mount Taranaki then, here on the North Island of New Zealand, this is it. One more push to see who will be amongst the elite teams to fight for gold at the Olympic Games next year. Let's get some thoughts beforehand.
Well, good day for us yesterday. We take a one goal lead into the match today. So it'll be a case of us getting a draw or a win. We'll see us through. And for Korea, they've got to try and overtake that one goal advantage. So it should be exciting.
And the Koreans posed quite a big challenge yesterday. What improvements are you looking for out of your side today?
Well, there's nothing too much that we didn't expect from Korea. They've got some real quality and some top players. And we saw some of those guys on display yesterday and causing a few problems. For us, you know, there's a few things we want to do a little bit better. We certainly want to hold the ball in the centre of the field better and just make sure we've got a good amount of possession of the ball. And it'll also be about just negating some of their threats. And they've got some good ones.
Yes, yesterday it lost our team. Then one goal difference lost. Today cannot serve our team. We will be go to the attacking player. But in the first until second half, it's the most important of the defense first. In the try the counter attack, it's after second half, we will be high pressure. And then the high attacking try, because we must today win. It possible is a one goal difference shootout going. The two goal difference will go to Tokyo next year. So it will be all the best today.
Thoughts of both coaches ahead of this one, as Korea are out already. That will never for them. They must win. Nothing less than that will do for them this afternoon in the Taranaki Spring Sunshine. And done in the final quarter from a piece of brilliance. One goal deficit is all that it is to turn around. And here come New Zealand, beaten by Australia in the Oceania Cup, which means these matches their only way of getting to Tokyo next year. The women's team are there. They're just an hour or so of action away from joining them. Before we get underway, as always, we will have the national anthems.
to the national anthem of New Zealand.
Passionate rendition of God Defend New Zealand. The coin toss with both captains. Vietnam Young of Korea to the left and Blair Tarrant to the right for the Black Stakes. And our two umpires today, Adam Cairns of Australia and Herman Montesstock, has been brought out of the box as he was on video umpire duty yesterday. New Zealand up against a Korea team who could potentially be the first away team throughout this qualifying process to book their place at the Olympic Games next year. Just one change to the starting 11 for New Zealand from yesterday, with Steve Edwards getting the nod ahead of Jared Panchier. Stephen Genesis' two first-half goals and his assist for Simon Child's winner going a long way in setting New Zealand up for a first-match victory. But half a job done at the halfway stage, they will look to the likes of Genesis and Inglis to lead the way again. Blair Tarrant captains, with Kane Russell a very good threat from penalty corners. As for Korea, they have quality and experience in abundance. However, from the start, Jang Jong-hyun, he does not get a run out from the start, only a reserve role for him. Oh Dae-kyun starts in his place, the only change from their starting lineup from yesterday. Lee Nam-young was central to their opening goal in the first game, with great hold-up play across the baseline to feed across, which was nudged in from close range. They have to win today, no ifs or buts about it. Huge crowd being asked if they're ready. In glorious sunshine, around 26 degrees at the start of this one. Second match between New Zealand and Korea. But as Darren Smith said, the New Zealand coach, they want to hold the ball centre field a lot better than what they did yesterday, keep possession, but also very aware of the quality shown from Korea. And his message is that they will attack today, and they have to. The high-pressure game, so much at stake. Smiles already on the face of Stephen Genesis. Well, he can have the same impact as what he had yesterday. One of seven players in this squad with well over 200 caps to his name. We are off and running then here from the Taranaki Hockey Club on what is a perfect day for a game of hockey. Clear blue skies above. New Zealand and Korea doing it one more time, but this is the big one. The Black Sticks with a slender one-goal advantage after yesterday's clash. Avoiding defeat is what they have to do. And as you can see on the score graphic to the bottom of your screen, 3-2 they lead on aggregate from match number one. So over to you, Korea, to see what you are made of. They didn't make Rio. I'm hoping that lightning doesn't strike twice for them, and that they can be a part of the Tokyo Olympic Games next year. Looking to get on with things quickly here, Kim Sung-kyu. This is Lee Nam-yong, looking to turn, but turning into trouble, and the help of Nick Woods can bring it away, and here he is, left side over halfway, just the touch off the foot. First goal will be crucial in the overall context, you feel, of this one. Will it go the way of the Black Sticks or Korea? Twice they had to fight back yesterday, did Korea. In the end, it was in the final quarter that New Zealand were able to get the victory. That's Edwards. Korea are able to bring it away now. Korea, who claimed silver at the Summer Olympics of 2000 in Sydney. It's as good as it's got for them. That's a fifth since then. New Zealand, who have been crowned Olympic champions once before.
Just kick the ball, boys.
Here is Hwang. Himself into a good position yesterday to try and feed off the threat of Lee Nam-yong to level things up first time around. But here is Simon Child taking it forward for New Zealand. Just stopped in his tracks. Keeping things going back for Nick Woods. Keeping the ball, it's something that Darren Smith will be looking for his team to improve on. But this is Ross now. Woods can gather it, and he's been able to do so. New Zealand still with the possession. And Cairns forcefully blowing his whistle. Free hit belonging to New Zealand. Here is Ross. Squeeze it into the circle. Korea have done enough. Chose Sukun. A little isolated at the moment, but he'll do well to try and find his way out, but only as far as Shea McAleese. Ross. Good pressure this from New Zealand. Can be found here shortly. Penalty corner, and it is to be the first of the game. Well, great skills along the baseline. And a real clattering of sticks, weren't they? So the first chance for New Zealand to threaten here from a set piece. This is where he came from. Hugo Inglis. Little shimmy, there's the trap, and another opportunity. First defender was quick out. So early pressure needing to be soaked up here by Correa. They come again, there's the trap. Oh, and so very nearly creeping in the corner. It's a little push and stopping things.
Straight off.
We will have a green card here.
Yes, I'm waiting whether he play or not.
Adam Cairns.
This one.
It's been stopped here for a referral.
David,
Yes.
We're looking for the foot on the line, please.
Okay, so we are looking for the foot on the line, goal line.
Clear for our video umpire, Javed Shaikh. Drop was good. Flick was on its way, and was that a foot or was that just excellent defense? Kim Seong-kyu was the man on the line from the flick. Just trying to find the right angle for our video umpire to be able to make his decision. May this be the better. That's where the green card came about for Edwards. But still, we wait. This is the original replay from behind the goal. Michael might have come off the stick and then onto the post. So it looks like they are the only two angles that are available.
Adam, can you hear me?
Here we go.
The video footage is not convincing, so there is no advice possible, but the team keeps their referral.
Okay, understand, mate. Now wait, guys, wait. Please come.
Did you get
I haven't finished yet. So this little incident down here, you better sit down because it's after that situation. We can't have guys pushing in and knocking guys over like that, okay? So,
get your message back here.
So the one afterwards where he's just bowled him over, I've got a big issue with, okay? Yeah. So, have a chat, I'll wait, I'll hold it. Make sure, I'll give him the benefit of the doubt there, okay?
So, benefit of the doubt from our umpire. Just a word to Blair Tarrant to get the message across that he's not going to be tolerating anything like that from Edwards. They keep the referral. But no further advice able to be given. Green card has not been awarded. But no further advice as to whether there was a touch on the foot on the line. So a free out here for Korea. It just couldn't quite find the clearest angle. From the angle from behind the goal, it did look like Kim Seong-kyu did use the stick onto the frame of the goal. So we continue. He's not in any mood to be messing around today, is he? Free hit going at New Zealand's way. New Zealand have started this first quarter well and on the front foot. Here comes the cross from Kane Russell. Chance for Korea to spark an attack of their own here through the captain. Just been nudged out. Oh, and there's they're coming together, although it's gone against Korea. Not hanging around New Zealand, great, playing with great intensity already. It goes again and taken down superbly well. And just up with the foot as well. As Charles to get on with things quickly. Career penalised for just invading the space as he was brought down the aerial pass. He's had a busy start to this one, hasn't he, Adam Cairns? Forward he goes. Free hit to Kareem.
Everybody fight, everybody fight. Everybody fight, seven, fight, stay.
Junk. Again, down the line, all the way back to halfway, and it just trickles through the legs. And down off the ball, controlled. It's coolly done from Woods. It offers the option for a return from Jared Panjia to go to the left this time. Here is Shea McAleese, Tarrant. Dane Lett, but to spin back and back to halfway they come here, New Zealand. One side or the other, Aaron Panjia starts to make his move, although his brother opts not to use it. This game being played in marvellous Stratford. It's been classed as a do or die weekend, as many of the matches have been described as. Korea coming into this one with a world ranking of 16. As mentioned, they didn't qualify for the Rio Olympic Games, silver in Sydney 2000. They do have a fine pedigree on the Asian scene, 4 gold medals at Asian Games. How they would love to be a part of an Asian Olympic Games next year. New Zealand keeping the ball well. It's forward by Lett. In the end, it's gone against Simon Child, who's been brought back into this squad for these matches. First time since Rio. 2017, he suffered a horrible hip injury. It's only this year that he has really returned to the sport. There were some concerns that he would never play again. That was the ultimate concern of Darren Smith, back six coach. Inglis. Woods. This is Aaron Panjia. Captain material, did captain the team of the Pro League. Intensity here from New Zealand is really good. Woods has been penalised. The high press from Inglis, stopping Korea making any further room. Going this man from Dunedin, 2 Olympics behind him in London and Rio. Just cannot seem to get out of their own half at the moment. Korea. Taken from the right place. Actually, the free hit has gone on with. Just loops up, so another free hit for New Zealand. Back off the foot this time. New Zealand's team who finished seventh at the last Olympic Games. Approaching 5 minutes for the end of the first quarter. Still goalless between New Zealand and Korea. 3-2. New Zealand have as a very, very slender advantage that one goal. Member of aggregate, if it is to be level, the aggregate scoreline at the end of this shootout drama we will need to determine who prevails and goes to Tokyo. Edwards stopped firmly right on the edge of the circle. Edwards again, not hanging around. Edwards, great skills. Korea frantically trying to keep New Zealand at bay. Childs loops up. Who's going to be on the end of this? Penalty corner. Looking up already, the penalty corner count. Loops up here, and then it was a case of who was the right place to bring this down, who is invading whose space. Although we're going to have a referral.
We are looking for a stick deflection or a goalkeeper deflection. So we are looking for a stick deflection or a goalkeeper deflection.
Is it deflected by a stick or off the goalkeeper? As though there might have been a touch off the black stick. Here we go.
Adam, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
There was a deflection from the New Zealand stick, so it's a free hit to the Korea.
So a free hit is the call for Korea. Keep the referral as well.
No, just in the middle here. That's where the danger is, just in the middle.
Dangerous play.
One more play,
Simon. It's been deemed by the officials.
Yep.
Working well, the video umpire. Good decisions have been made. Kim Ki-hoon, essentially the youngest member of this group of players here this weekend. Bit tight in the corner. There is Kim Ki-hoon again. We'll come within the last year is caps that he's made for Korea. Themselves out of a tight spot pretty well. Over halfway they come. Lee Jung-jin. He get the better of Led, twisting and turning. Will be a long corner. This is a lot more encouraging from Korea. As we enter the final 3 minutes of this first quarter. Kim Ki-hoon again. Usually pretty close in contests between these two. New Zealand with defending to do this time. Into the circle, brilliant turn, wonderful play. And in the end, Montesdorca just brings a stop to a proceedings for Korea. Go Inglis. Greatest achievement at an Olympic Games in 1976, winning gold. First side ever from outside Europe or Asia to win gold. Wild one from Inglis. Turnover here for Korea. Taken quickly by Lee Nam-yong, the restart from the sideline. There is Oh Dae-kyun. He's actually the oldest member of the group of players. 12 years a senior member of the group for Korea, 37 years of age. There are many a player in this Korean team who are wrong side of 35, really. So one last chance for them, you feel, to be reaching a Olympic Games. Lee Sung-hoon. Give it away. Final 60 seconds we have entered the end of this first quarter. Korea looking to finish strongly. Advantage being played for the Black Sticks. Aaron Panchir through the legs. Lee Jung-yun. Back Elise launches it. And taken down. Jacob Smith breaks down for New Zealand. Lee Nam-yong. It's the second stick away. Forced towards the circle, but that will be that. As the hooter sounds, the end of the first quarter here. And New Zealand have had the better of it, no doubt about that. But still, it is goalless in this second match, and still they have that one goal advantage as well. 0-0, 3-2 on aggregate to New Zealand. It's been pretty tight and pretty frenetic at times. Still all to play for here in Stratford. Still that threat from Korea, despite the fact that New Zealand have had the better of the opportunities created, and they've had penalty corner opportunities too. Skills we've seen from the likes of Edwards down this right flank, but stubborn they have been so far. Have Korea a few reversals when it comes to decisions made by umpires. Haven't met New Zealand and Korea since before Rio into these qualifiers. Series event which Korea lost 2-0 with the Black Sticks. They are represented well. Back underway. Which way is the pendulum going to swing? Here's Ross looking to get New Zealand on the front foot straight away. Inglis just being in from the side for New Zealand. Spent much of the first half so far inside the Korean half. To the circle, that's Inglis. And Stanley might be on. Oh, no, they've got it. And it's that man again. Stephen Jeunesse scored twice yesterday. He opened the scoring yesterday, and he's done exactly the same here. Ideal start to the second quarter for New Zealand. And once more, Stephen Jeunesse with the reactions. Really well taken. He's having a pretty good weekend, isn't he? On a personal note. He is always a threat from that sort of area. Scored three goals throughout the Pro League, all from open play. And a player who is slowly creeping up to 250 caps. So 244 now. Didn't react well, didn't he? Such an important moment in the match. The first goal of this one. And that's 4-2 now in aggregate, so two goals that they need to recover here, Korea.
Right there, this way. Hey, here, 5 meters, reception. Recession.
They've had to bide their time, New Zealand, certainly. They have got their just reward. Free hit looking to keep the pressure on and to try and get another, which would really make it a huge mountain to climb for Korea, as big as Mount Taranaki itself and the surrounding areas here, the North Island. Penalized. 232nd cap for New Zealand today for Hugo Inglis. Fabulous vision to find Lee Nam-young. Get the pass right, they're into the circle here, Korea. Looking for a response, oh, just nudged away. So important. And now it might just work out for Jeunesse to bring it forward for New Zealand from one end to the other. Jeunesse linking up with Simon Child, who both of them had a wonderful game yesterday. And the interplay between the two, especially causing so many issues for Korea. Lee Nam-young looking for some inspiration from the captain. I think 17 years as a senior international for Lee Nam-young, extraordinary. Scored against New Zealand at the Beijing Games. Lee Seung-hyun, Lee Pink. Blair Tarrant taking over now. Aaron Punch here. Here is Aaron Punch here again. His brother from Auckland of Indian descent. My grandfather came to New Zealand in the 1920s. Says he wants to follow in the footsteps of the likes of Bevan Hari and Umesh Parag, former New Zealand players. Jump from Jared to link up with Child. Free hit for New Zealand. A lot closer to the circle. It's to be taken from. It's to travel 5 meters before it enters the circle. That's really well played. Oh, they could be in for another. Kim Jae-yoon doing enough in goal. Lee Nam Yong up against Aaron Panjia. He's brought it away well, the captain, to spring an attack for Korea. Something needs to happen, you feel, from there. So, as it was fired in to Kim Jung-hyo. Missed the connection with his stick, and it struck his foot in the end. There's the danger. There is the danger on the counter. Got his execution all wrong. It's a big ask, you feel, for Korea, but they get another one just before half-time, level the score on the day, and start from a one-goal deficit as they did at the very start of the action today. Give them some belief going into the second half. New Zealand always looking a threat. Long corner it will be for the Black Sticks. They were royally beaten after a tough Oceania Cup battle with Australia. Contrast to their women's team, who already booked their place in Tokyo after their Oceania Cup success over Australia. Preparation as well, New Zealand, with a warm-up season with a series, I should say, with the Olympic host Japan. Here is McAleese. That's well cut out by John Byung-jin. Taken over nicely by Tarrant. And is that to be a finish? There is. Oh. It is a crucial goal for New Zealand. And the biggest smile belongs to Sam Lane, it looks like. Following up, Sam Lane. Into an empty goal. And New Zealand, they're well on their way now. Two goals to the good here on the day, and that's 5-2 now on aggregate. Sam Lane, who grew up on a dairy farm near Timaru in the southwest of Christchurch. He scored three goals in the Pro League. Such a threat he is from penalty corners, but on this occasion, from open play, he was able to provide the telling finish for New Zealand. Now Korea really do have it all to do. Black Sticks turning the screw. Skills from Inglis. Where do Korea go from here? They will keep on fighting. Give so much yesterday. Full credit has to go to the Black Sticks captain, Blair Tarrant, as well, for his fabulous run to make it all happen. And the build-up and gobbling up the opportunity as it squirmed loose. This man right here, Sam Lane. Dylan Thomas into the circle. just outside the infringement.
Right here, big fight. All the way in. Get bigger, bigger.
Good. So we approach the final 5 minutes. Route to half time. New Zealand in complete control in Stratford. Janess and Lane, the scorers. Every time they scored yesterday until they eventually scored their third goal, they were pegged back by Korea, but haven't really seen the same amount of attacking intent from Korea as we did yesterday. And that's full credit to the Black Sticks as well, the way that they have controlled this game. It's well won back. Jared Panchir just couldn't gather it. Lee Nam-yong. Tarrant get things going again. Reached his milestone of 200 caps for New Zealand during the Oceania Cup. To return for the Oceania Cup after back surgery in May. Tarrant, who, along with the likes of Russell and Inglis and Ross, all in their trade with Otago Boys High School. Enjoying the Sunday afternoon entertainment here in Stratford, the supporters of the Black Sticks, as they know that they are in a very healthy position. Woods across, he has been penalised. Looks rather bemused. Jungmanje. Aerial pass effective, into the circle they are, flashing it across. I think a penalty corner has been awarded for Korea. Argentinian official very quick to award the penalty corner. This is how it all came about.
15 seconds. You can refer whenever you want. 10-0.
There's been
start, okay? And the whistle.
Corey Bennett, I think, has been penalised for a push in the back. Reason why it's been awarded.
Okay, look at the ball.
Lee Nam-yong looking for the deflection. Just didn't work out. Summing up how it has all gone for Korea so far, who are so dangerous when it comes to set pieces. We got on with by Edwards. That's Inglis. Woods. Ross, comfortable in possession, New Zealand are. To this right side now for Russell to try and have a burst down the line, although stopped in his tracks by Lee Nam-yong. New Zealand able to turn it over again. This is Simon Child. Still he goes on, Child, and he still has the possession. Quite able to keep it in play.
You're coming here too. Yelled at me over here. If you yelled at me over here, you've run in to start something over here that's totally unnecessary. Have a think about what you're doing.
Yeah.
I think that's what you call being told. A good telling off to Steve and Jeunesse. Final 2 minutes. Jeunesse just loves scoring in Stratford, it seems. Another goal today. It's the two that he scored yesterday. Just a little further back, this free hit needs to be taken from. What's it going to work out for? Correa maybe a final flourish. The first half for them here. Give them some belief going into the second half if they're able to break down New Zealand. If it all remains the way that it is at the moment, it's going to be another home nation booking their place at Tokyo next year. To have an away success so far. Ranked nations at home.
Hold there, Simon.
Stick is on the floor, 22.
Just not look their dangerous selves as they were yesterday.
Okay.
Career.
That's good. Thank you.
It's Woods. Dane Lett. Real pass. Put out in the end by Kim Seung-kyu. It out in the pads of Kim Jae-yeon, but in the end it's New Zealand with a clear advantage. They have been terrific in this first half with goals from Jeunesse and from Sam Lane as well. And Korea, 3 goals to make up in a match that they simply have to win today if they are to be in with a chance, or if they are to be going to Tokyo. But New Zealand have other ideas. So goals from Jeunesse and from Sam Lane have New Zealand 2 up at halftime. 5-2 they lead on aggregate.
Come on, get out of it.
He's done. All over. Gee, you've got to clean your eye out. You can get a sweat out. Come on, Elliot. Boy. Well, mate, how's the game, you reckon? No, good. Really ridiculous. Good part. You can win this. You can win this. We'll make a count up to him, let you know how that sounds. All right. Well, he's done extremely well. Didn't let him put us down. Ah, there's my absolute right flank partner here in Motorsport, the world's largest manufacturer of two wheelers, for being a global leadership partner of FIH and Dream 11. Matt Pick and Osaka for being the global suppliers of FIH. Hockey New Zealand also want to thank the official partners of the FIH Hockey Import Olympic Qualifier, Banded Windows and Doors, Principal Partner of Hockey New Zealand, all the driving force behind the great six, Wardrobe World, Continental Homes and the Taranaki Energy Trust. And its official suppliers, Computer Concepts Limited, the TSP Asia New Zealand Foundation. Help me bring some pies chips here this afternoon.
Welcome back to our coverage of New Zealand against Korea in the FIH Hockey Olympic qualifiers. New Zealand 2 goals to the good against Korea, and they are extending their aggregate scoreline as well. 3 goals Korea now have to make up to stand a chance of qualifying for the Olympics. Goals from Stephen Jeunesse and from Sam Lane. So Stephen Jeunesse onto 3 goals for the weekend in qualifying. He's just one behind now, Ming van der Veerden, who leads the way with 4 goals throughout qualifying. And Sam Lane also getting in on the act too, as New Zealand have dominated the first 2 quarters. This is the best of the action from the first 2 quarters. Stephen Jeunesse, just as he was yesterday, right place, right time to finish off here. Lovely controlled finish, wasn't it, on the volley? Got a very important goal as well. The first goal of this contest coming in 3-2 up on aggregate. Korea had a few flourishes forward, but just not able to have a right attacking touch in the crucial areas inside the circle at the other end. Full credit to Tarrant. And then doing it up as well, Jacob Smith on the slide. And Sam Lane did the rest. So that's 2-0. 5-2 at aggregate lead. And such a tall order now for Korea to try an overturn. Really having their fair share of luck when it comes to the set piece as well. With Mount Taranaki watching over us. What a perfect day for a game of hockey this Sunday afternoon. It is all going the way of New Zealand as they look to join the women's team in Tokyo next year. Stats and facts of what has gone before us, fairly even at times, but New Zealand just looking a lot more threatening. Looking to maintain this fine record of all home nations qualifying for the Olympics through the qualifiers. A career who, between 1908 and 1984, didn't actually participate in the Olympic Games. 1988 in Seoul was their very first appearance. They finished 10th Since then, they haven't really been able to reach the same heights as what they were able to do in 2000 in Sydney. It looks as though, if an incredible turnaround is not to be created here this afternoon, it will be consecutive Olympic Games that they will not be involved in. Nation ranked 16th. The FIH World Rankings. Spring has struck and an element of summer here as well. Temperatures around the 26, 27 degree mark here in North Island today. Struggling between Auckland and Wellington out on the northwest coast of New Zealand. To bring some smiles back to the faces of many a New Zealand sports fan. Not had the best of times of it, have they, in the Rugby World Cup. The All Blacks, famous All Blacks, beaten at the semi-final stage. Of course, the cricket team in the Cricket World Cup, beaten in the final to England. In extraordinary circumstances. Blair Tarrant getting his message across.
Yeah, buddy. Come on, yeah.
Careful.
Corey Bennett recently clocking 100 caps. And Hayward has been pretty quiet so far. So we are back underway here at the Taranaki Hockey Club. All about New Zealand at the moment. And they are clear as day favourites now, barring some incredible turnaround from Korea. Although, from what we have seen in qualifiers so far, especially last weekend, nothing will be completely determined until the very, very final hooter whistle. Some incredible turnarounds, certainly in women's qualification with India in the United States yesterday. India very nearly being sent out of the reckoning for a place at the Olympics. An extraordinary comeback from the United States in the end. It just wasn't enough. Down safely here by Jang Jun-hyun. Looking to avoid the puddle that is developed with the sprinkler system at half time.
No, your foot, play.
Korea looking to bring it away. There is Lee Jung-jun. He's used to get away from English pretty well there. Haven't seen this high press attack that we thought we would see from Korea. Hwang. Everything's quickly here. That's a really good block. Looks like they went five.
Outside.
Feels as though Korea need to get the next goal. Free hit belongs to them. Lee Sung-gil. Jang Jun-hyun plays it to the left and his captain will give it him back now. Been firm in defence, have New Zealand, and taking their chances when those chances have come about. Lee Nam-yong. Jung Man-jae celebrated his 150th cap yesterday. Just a little rush, but full credit has to go as well to New Zealand. Their own press, defensive press also. Started well at the beginning of this third quarter of Korea. Kim Sung-kyu into the corners with Cho Seok-yoon. And it will be a free hit. Still not being taken from the right place. And he comes again. And the reactions this time from Leon Hayward. First time we've actually mentioned his name in play. Jang Jong-hyun. Here's Kim Sung-kyu. Has done well, looking to enter the circle, but the defense again from New Zealand is very good. Maintaining the clean sheet at the moment. Seventh in 2016 in Rio, ninth in London, bettered sixth place in the Olympic Games since they won gold in 1976, New Zealand. Haunted in the Commonwealth Games final at last year as well. You know who. The familiar enemy and foe, that is Australia. Actually finished eighth in the Pro League. The left flank, Lee Sung-kyu, he's nudging it forward. Lee Ju-young, Oh Dae-kyun, plenty of possession without any real penetration. They are going to get a penalty corner here. Our career, so a chance to try and work something, because they need some sort of sparkle.
Off the board, guys. Time's up on the board, okay? 25. 20, up on the board, buddy. Up the board.
To the circle it goes, and then...
Okay, let's go, please.
It's as though where Child completely missed the ball as it then came back for his foot. For 140 goals to his name now, Simon Child. 142, in fact. For his goal yesterday. It's the trap, there's the flank, and wide. It's a lot more purpose about career. They need to show that, certainly as they're chasing the game. Target was the flick from Jeon Byung-jin. Meanwhile, down at the other end, control from Lane let him down. There are two scorers today. Well, he wasn't selected for the World Cup or for the Commonwealth Games in 2018. Sam Lane. Shane McAleese, Napier born and bred. Three-time Olympian, says he had the bug to play the game from the age of 10. And he's had that bug ever since. It's not got away from him at all. He's one of only four players who have ever played 300 games for New Zealand, with the likes of Phil Burrows and Ryan Archibald, Dean Cousins. Fantastic company to be in. Odaikian. It's a really good block. Tidying up now is Woods. Woods. He's done well to get the free hit, and then McAleese can send it long up into those clear skies. Inglis taking over now, advancing into the circle. Oh! Looking for that third goal, which would surely put the game away. And the reverse. That was Jeunesse also. I think he was expecting this. So Sam Lane, in fact, just shaving the stick. One side to the other for Korea. Who's going to provide that bit of inspiration? As it leaps up, it will be a free hit for Korea. Into the circle, rather central. Just to travel 5 meters before it enters the circle. Lower the block from Woods. Really, really good. Really good defense from Nick Woods. It breaks down from Lee Sungil. Just typifying everything that is not going their way today. Chance to use the right side again. Here's Odaikun. Long corner for Korea. Certainly a third quarter that has belonged to them. Jung Man-jae keeps some width here. Into the circle, just nudged away by New Zealand. Blair Tarrant getting it forward. And so the more that they're going to be pushing forward, Korea just leaves the space at the back for New Zealand to try and penetrate, and a penalty corner has been awarded. Penalised for a rather cynical clearance out of play, deliberately playing it out.
This is not impossible, this is a vision of our own story. Opportunity for the black sticks.
Time, boys. Zero, we must start.
Jeunesse will go across to inject here. So many options for New Zealand at penalty corners.
Ready, keeper. Look at the ball.
Everyone waits. Kate Russell! He does what he does best. Kane Russell, who is one of those really, really strong. And penalty corner experts for New Zealand. Straight through the eye of a needle into the goal. All of his goals in the Pro League were from penalty corners. And here he is in qualifying, helping send New Zealand on their way. Everything working perfectly for New Zealand. 3-0 up, 6-2 in aggregate. No way back really for Korea now. Russell, who was a pretty good javelin thrower, apparently, in his school days, junior, senior national records. He's not bad. He's a drag flicker, is he? Korea have had a lot of possession in this third quarter, in this sort of area. Not really being able to penetrate the New Zealand defence. Typically, it is them that go down the other end. And get the crucial goal from Kane Russell, 42 minutes. Disappointingly given away, though, by New Zealand. Out to the sideline, lovely turn by Kim Seung-kyu. To the circle, looking for some luck here, and they're going to get the penalty corner.
Countdown
to be ready. Players to get their safety kit on and ready, the New Zealand defenders.
Five, guys, five.
Lee Jung-jun to inject.
Go Black.
Jang Jun-hyun awaits. Oh, it's well left and shifted. Long corner it will be. A bit of variation from Korea here. Just a glance away by Nick Russell, Nick Woods, it looked like. The decisive touch. Preparations will pretty much start straight away for New Zealand and for those of the nations that have qualified for the Olympic Games. Small matter of the second edition of the Pro League to come next year as well. Start of January, well, mid-January it all begins. We'll be using the Pro League as crucial match preparation. To improve on the position that they ended this year's Pro League on New Zealand.
Excellent, Dane.
Inside the final minutes of this third quarter.
Boys.
To halfway they come.
Let's go, Black.
Nudge down the line. It's in by Lee Nam-yong. Free hit, which he gets on with quickly. Lee Nam-yong, that's really good from him. Into the circle they go, and they just cannot find a way to go. And that should be that for this third quarter. There it is. Well, the commanding lead for New Zealand. They have Korea with the better of that third quarter, but it is to be New Zealand who were to get the third goal.
Keep up. Liquid refreshments.
In 15 minutes, Korea need to score a four goals if they've got a chance to even force a shootout. New Zealand 3-0 up, and it's 6-2 on aggregate. 3-0. Well, they've had their moments, but this was where the penalty corner came about. In fact, that was the opportunity for Inglis and Lane, but this is where the penalty corner came for Russell. Three was illegally played out by a career, and they profited. Kane Russell, who is a very accomplished drag flicker, getting the job done. Plenty to take and to learn for this Korean team, in which a lot of these players you feel will be coming to the end of their time as well with Korea. You think of the likes of Oh Dae-kyun, 37, Lee Nam-young's 36, Lee Sung-gil as well, 36 years of age, Jang Jun-hyun, 35. What are these Korean players really there? Last opportunity to try and claim a place at the Olympic Games. But New Zealand, over the two contests, doing enough. And especially here in Stratford today. The stronger of the two nations. Janess, Lane and Russell, the scorers. Actually, the music has stopped on the PA system. But Korea will keep going. They will keep on going. Such is the attitude instilled. They just haven't had enough in them in this game here today. They haven't shown enough intent in this game today. New Zealand have been by far more clinical when their moments have come to shine. He goes again. And the aerial played up quickly, which Inglis has taken it down. Child, unlucky. Coach Darren Smith was actually his first ever roommate during a series in Malaysia back in 2005. Simon Child, know each other pretty well. The team for the first time since Rio, scored four goals of those Rio games. Simon Child. Here come Korea. Into the circle, but well snuffed out. Though handed straight back to them. Long corner it will be. Take it in the right place. One corner, right now. It was a long corner, and it's been overturned.
Back here, please. That's good, thank you.
Think of the nations who are already there. 12 teams will qualify. Argentina, South Africa, Belgium, Australia, joined by Spain, by Canada in dramatic circumstances last weekend, and the Netherlands also, who did enough to blitz Pakistan in the end. Though it wasn't exactly straightforward for Max Caldas' side from the first game. Here come New Zealand, looking to add to the score. Chenez on the turn, close to the baseline. Chenez just looking to lift it over the goalkeeper. He's had a very good weekend, Stephen Chenez, on a personal note. These goals that have helped New Zealand on their way. By Jiwoo Chong. Picking in field here and into the circle and right at the very edge, and there was a deflection on that. And a scramble that anywhere will do for New Zealand. Leon Hayward determined to make sure that he maintains his clean sheet.
Right there.
Lee Sung-hoon. Want to get his Dane Letts. New Zealand with Jared Panchir. Chenez. Jay back out to the right side now as he's played back by Odai Kun. Just happy to sit and let Korea have possession here. New Zealand, such a positive position to be in. The game is in the bag, really. Tokyo, here they come. Barring an extraordinary collapse, it would be. Lee Joo Young. Oh, Dae Kyun. The free hit here for Korea. To the circle, the free hit has been given against Panchir. Another Olympic Games which they're going to miss out on here, Korea.
Harry, get free! You go back west! You go back west!
That's Kim Ki-hoon. Lee Sung-gil. Pick up off a black stick. It'll be a long corner, it looks like. Flying in towards the circle. It was well blocked again by this New Zealand defence, who at the moment shall not be beaten.
Yes.
The 13th meeting between these two nations since 2012. looking like a sixth victory for New Zealand.
It's a Korean team's referral. We are asking for a stick and a penalty corner inside.
So a referral here.
So we are looking for penalty corner, stick tackle inside the 23.
Yes.
Stick tackle, that is what we're looking for here. Just looking for the right angle to see where, inside the 23, whether there was a stick tackle. Here we go. Just there. The incoming Nick Ross. Javid Shaikh has his decision.
Adam, I have a decision for you.
Yes, Javid.
There is a stick tackle, so it's a penalty corner, and penalty Korea team keep their referral.
Thank you.
So they ask for it, they keep the referral, and they get the decision their way.
Stop changing. He's had a good look at it, guys.
Just to try and bring some joy for Korea.
It's a matter of interpretation.
Okay, guys, let's go, please. All right, guys, come on.
Still New Zealand not quite ready yet as Korea have been made to wait, but here we go.
Ready, go Black!
There's the injection. Taken back into the circle. Quickly out was Jacob Smith. Very quick off the mark was Jacob Smith with the first block. Another penalty corner has been awarded.
Okay, guys, let's go,
against Nick Woods.
Let's go nice and quick here, boys.
Here we go once more.
Oh. Let's go, please!
Jang Jung-hyun, he waits. It will be him this time, and wide he goes, and not for the first time in this one. Korea are off target when it comes to a PC. They're going to get a penalty corner of their own here in New Zealand. So from one end to the other. So quick to break away. Clearly coming off the foot there of Lee Sung-kyun. It's clear as day, a decision. So successful they have been so far from a penalty corner. Kane Russell executing the flick, the little shimmy. And here they come again, but this runner was good. The block was good at the expense of another penalty corner.
Sir.
Discussion as to how they're going to go about with this particular one.
Whistle again.
With the whistle, we can play. Ready, keeper. You got the ball.
Here comes the injection. There's the trap. And the save was good to deny Russell a second goal.
In the middle.
In the middle, guys. There you go.
One big pad up to the right. Nick Woods being awarded the Player of the Match award. The Black Sticks. Woods has had a very good weekend overall, really. Is Tarrant. To go one way and then just to go forward this time. Nick Ross. In the old man's footsteps, there is a former Black Stick himself. There is Woods. So playing it forward. Back with Lee Jung Young. Keeping it close to the sideline. Against Woods, turning Nick Woods inside out. Obstruction being called. Approaching 5 minutes then. Here's Lee Sung Gil. Further ground being able to be made. Space now, Lee Jung Jun wanting it, getting it. Jang Jung Hyun to the right corner this time for Korea, but so quick. There is a New Zealand face right in the face of a Korean player. Having a goalkeeper change here. Okay. He goes to the circle. He's going to get on the end of it as it's frantic defence from New Zealand. Long corner for Korea.
Dennis, hands off, Dennis, hands
off. Chang playing it forward now for his captain, Lee Nam-yong. Completely open goal, all attackers. As Kim Jae-hyun makes his way to the bench area. 3.5 minutes of the match remaining, and the danger now is with New Zealand on the counter, and this might just work out in their favour. Dylan Thomas inside the circle waiting for things, although Child just delays. Keep it in the corner through Jeunesse now. New Zealand have the free hit, which they will certainly not be in any real rush to get on with, to frustrate Korea even more.
5 meters, back. You can play. Yes.
Jeunesse restarts. Just about keeping it in play.
Stop the ball to play. Stop it.
Just inside the New Zealand half, but pushed back into their own half here, Korea. Kang Min-kyu. Just not been their day on an attacking front for Korea today. Just two more minutes and then the celebrations can start for New Zealand. Looking to force it into the circle. There was a coming together there. They're looking for a push.
Are you telling me what your question is?
And, they're going to get it as well as the penalty corner has been awarded. We're going to have a referral.
Yes.
The New Zealanders are saying there's no push. I believe the guy's tripped him there. So that's what the decision was for PC.
So we are looking for the push inside the D.
Was it a push?
At the top of the circle.
Or was it not a push? Here we go. The arm does come up to the back of Huang there, certainly by Aaron Panjip. Straight away appealing for this. Let's look for Aaron Panjip, 24. And this is a clear angle, but you can see the right arm and the right hand on the back.
Adam,
here's the call.
There is no clear reason to change your decision. It's a penalty corner, and New Zealand lose their referral.
Thank you.
So it's New Zealand who lose their referral. It was they that were asking for the call to check it again.
Yes.
Like no clear reason to change things. Can they at least have something to shout about here? Korea. The minute 41 remaining on the clock. It needs to be Jang, and still New Zealand shall not be beaten. Really good save. Really good from Leon Haywood. He's had a busier second half. Certainly, Leon Haywood.
Okay, we are looking for the push inside the D.
That's another referral here. Push inside the D. That is the call. That's the save from Haywood. And they're looking for a push. There, that's what they're looking at. Kane Russell, is he going to be the guilty party? High shot from behind the goal possibly wasn't the clearest of views. Is this to go against Russell? Possibly wasn't even the better of that, but the two angles again, that one. Javichaik wants to have a look at it from high above again. So it was nudged forward. Is there enough there for Kane Russell to be penalised? is the call from Javid Sheikh.
There is no clear reason to change your decision. Free out to the New Zealand.
Nothing in it.
Lose the referral.
Okay. So that's the end of Korea's referrals, and just a free out it will be. Inside the last 90 seconds. New Zealand on the verge of celebrations to be joining the women's team as well in Tokyo next year. At the pinnacle of sport at the Olympic Games. Through the legs, towards the edge of the circle. Korea been a lot better in the second half, but it's the way that New Zealand took their chances. Clinical and effective, and here they are again. Of course, that Korea don't have a goalkeeper at the moment. High press from New Zealand, and now the crowd start to react. And that's it. New Zealand have done it. Many congratulations to Darren Smith and to New Zealand. The Black Sticks are on their way to Tokyo. At the end, it's a convincing, commanding showing here in Stratford. And they will be amongst the elite names at the Tokyo Olympics next year. Korea gave it all. Just the one goal was the difference at the start of play, but New Zealand taking their chances, and in the end, they have run out. 3-0 victors over Korea. And overall, 6-2 aggregate victory. New Zealand will be the Olympics next year. Well, it just wasn't to be for Korea and for many of their experienced names, but New Zealand will have two teams at the Tokyo Olympics next year. Delight for many here in Stratford. Stephen Jeunes with a couple of goals yesterday. He got on the score sheet again today. Kane Russell effective from a penalty corner, with Sam Lane also on target today. And let's have a look at how it all unfolded. New Zealand with the crucial first goal coming the way from Jeunes, taking his chance so well, just like he did yesterday from similar positions. Korea kept on trying to be a threat, but it wasn't their day in front of goal. And here was Lane making it two. And they were well on the way at this point, New Zealand. Korea far more of a threat in the second half. At set pieces where they can be so dangerous, it just wasn't to be their day. Off target on a number of occasions. And New Zealand were happy just to sit back and allow Korea to try and threaten in the second half. But when they did get a penalty corner of their own, Kane Russell thought that he would get in on the act, and he did so efficiently. And that was the third goal. They just couldn't find a way beyond Leon Haywood. He came up with some smart saves in the end as well for New Zealand. So let's have a look at the stats and facts. New Zealand with three goals in this one. Although Korea with more in the way of circle penetrations, but that was possibly because of their intentions in the second half. One more penalty corners, but just nothing to show for it all today. So let's get a word with New Zealand and their player of the match. Nick Woods is downstairs, ready to talk to us.
So congratulations, Nick, on a fantastic performance today and being named man of the match. So how does it feel to having qualified for the Olympic Games now?
Oh, it's a huge achievement for us. We've done so much work over the past 6 months to get to this position, and it's just another step forward for us towards Olympics.
And what do you think it means to the country, for everyone, for what? Yeah.
It's huge, man. Like, hockey in New Zealand's growing, and for the sport in New Zealand, it's a massive achievement for us.
Awesome. Thank you. Congratulations, and enjoy your celebration.
So the words from Nick Woods, so much preparation. And they've been able to get their just rewards. Let's have a word with the coach.
So congratulations, Darren. Fantastic performance. How does it feel?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I just think nice to get it done with a 3-0 result, and thought the boys played well and some good goals, and good to get the ticket to Tokyo. Everyone wants that, and fantastic for us.
Congratulations, and go enjoy yourself.
Thanks, mate. Thank you.
One-time Olympian of the 2004 Games. Korea will take plenty out of these matches, but despair and disappointment for many. So close, but in the end, New Zealand just too good overall. They're getting a great ovation, and so they should as well. And they've been backed with a good crowd as well here this weekend. New Zealand by far the better of the two. The higher ranked nation going through and on their way to Tokyo. So plenty happening all over, and still so much to be determined as well, with Great Britain in a fine position in the men's and women's qualifiers, Germany as well. India have already been able to do it, although it's finally poised between Ireland and Canada in women's qualifying when they return in Dublin later on. 0-0 against Canada. So the celebrations belong to New Zealand. They will be on their way to Tokyo. Many congratulations to them. One-time gold medalist at the Olympic Games in 1976. And they will be amongst the finest nations to grace this game at the Tokyo Olympics, joining the women's team as well. So they will have two teams in Tokyo at the Olympic Games next year. The Black Sticks getting the job done over Korea here in Stratford. Hope you've enjoyed our coverage here this weekend. And New Zealand, job done for them. Winners yesterday and winners today as well by 6-2 on aggregate. Thanks for joining us. Let's do this.